Thank you, Sarah, for volunteering.
We're going to demonstrate the movie technique slash tell the story. And what we're doing here is we're not looking at a big traumatic event, not under these circumstances, but what I'd like to demonstrate is actually how we break down a memory that's distressing. And what we're looking at is all the reactions to this memory, so that we can methodically use tapping on all those emotions. So for example, shock, anger, frustration, sadness, so that eventually Sarah can tell me what happened again without all the reactions. And also we can establish what did you make that mean? So we can look at what the belief is around that event. Because when we do enough of working in these memories, we can start collapsing core beliefs like I'm not worthy. And so you start to get a sense of, well, I actually am worthy, because you're not carrying those stories with you anymore. What often happens, of course, in those events is we go also into either fight, flight, or freeze. And that can create all sorts of future problems. In similar situations, you might react in the same way. You might retract, you might freeze, you might want to run away. So this is interrupting that pattern, so allowing you to move on and be free, basically. Good. So first we want to establish that it's not too traumatic. And I just want you to, without going into the details, just have a little think. Maybe you need to close your eyes, just to check out of 10, how intense you think that might be if you were to go there.
Six, seven?
Six or seven. So it's over a five. So we want to just take the edge off. So we're going to get the title of this movie in your mind. So can you just give me a title? It doesn't have to be anything really descriptive. Just something simple.
Nurturing.
Okay, so all we're going to do is actually we're just going to go straight to the top of the head. And you can tap along if you want. So we're just going to say this nurturing movie.
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 This movie about nurturing.
This movie about nurturing.
This nurturing movie.
This nurturing movie.
This nurturing movie.
This nurturing movie.
And we're not going into it. I'm staying you focused with me, but we're just calming the nervous system down, allowing you to feel safer to share your story. Under the arm, this nurturing movie.
This nurturing movie.
This nurturing movie. And we'll just take a big breath in and let it go. One simple round, no setup statement, no nine gamut. We'll just do a check-in, maybe just have a little think again.
It's gone down.
It's gone down a bit. That's so what number would it be? It was a six or a seven?
Five.
A five. Does that mean you're four or five?
Yeah.
So the question really needs to be, are you comfortable just starting to tell me what happened?
Yeah.
Yeah, because if she's not, her four or five might actually be a lot higher as far as intensity. Mm-hmm. So I would just do a few more rounds until you felt comfortable. Okay, so that's good. So all we're going to do now is I'm going to just get you to start telling me what happened. Mm-hmm. My role is to really keep checking what's happening in your body, because often what happens is you'll just keep talking and you won't pick up on that because you'll just want to keep telling the story. So if you feel something, will you let me know? And I'll also be mindful of what's going on.
Good.
Okay, so just tell me a story.
So it's about parenting.
Yes.
My son.
Yes.
And conflicting views on how to parent.
Mm-hmm.
So when I was about 1.5, 2, was in my family in-law's house in France, and I started to cry.
You did?
No, no.
No, it's not to
no,
cry.
I started, no, yeah. My son started to cry. And it was bedtime, and I got criticized to around attachment parenting.
So when you say that, I got criticized, yeah. Does that cause a reaction?
Because as a young mum, not too sure what to do, and
so what's
got
the
very
feeling?
Different views.
Yeah, so that being criticized, what do you feel
insecurity?
Right now?
Yeah.
And you feel it now? Do you have a reaction now when you think about being criticized?
I do,
And where do you feel that in your body?
In my head.
Yes.
Yeah.
Out of 10?
Six.
Six,
seven.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we're just going to actually go side of the hand, even though?
Even though?
Is it sadness or what's the emotion? about
just feeling judged.
Yeah.
So
even though?
Even though?
I have this feeling.
I have this feeling.
About being judged.
About being judged.
I love and accept myself anyway.
I love and accept myself anyway.
Even though when I remember.
Even though when I remember.
Being criticized.
Being
have this in my head right now.
And I have this in my head right now.
I love and accept myself anyway.
I love and accept myself.
Top of the head. I'm just going to try and establish the feeling about being criticised. Would it be sadness? Would it be...
insecurity.
Yeah, so just say that word because that's the word that keeps you there.
Yeah.
Yeah? This insecure feeling.
This insecure feeling.
This insecure feeling.
This insecure feeling.
So I'm, yeah, feeling insecure.
Feeling insecure.
Feeling insecure in my head right now.
Feeling insecure in my head right now.
This insecure feeling.
This insecure feeling.
Being criticized.
Being criticized.
For my parenting.
For my parenting.
This insecure feeling.
This insecure feeling.
Tapping the ribs. Feeling vulnerable.
Feeling vulnerable.
This insecure feeling.
This insecure.
Nice breath in, let it go. So we're just going to do a little check-in. What number is the insecure feeling in your head when you recall being criticised right now?
It's low, much more lowered.
Much lower.
Less overwhelmed. But
good, so can you give me a number on that insecure feeling in your head right now?
3 or 4.
3 or 4.
Would you mind just showing me?
Okay. So you're feeling more comfortable. Can you tell me that bit again of the story up to that point? And just see.
So what? Repeating?
Yes, repeating, yes.
So when I was about 1.5, 2, and my family in Noah's house, and I started to cry and
yes.
I took care of Noah, and I got criticised for my parenting style.
So as you said that now,
I'm
fine, good. So you see how we just tested that?
Mm-hmm. I felt before I was possibly getting teary.
Yes.
And now I'm fine.
Okay, good. We've got a dog in the house who's eating a fly. Okay, so now we're going to ask you to continue with the story. So can you tell us what happened next?
So I took him upstairs and we do co-sleeping.
Yeah.
And breastfeeding. And yeah, I got all these really nasty comments. He's going to stay with you in the bed till he's 18. Leave him to cry. You shouldn't do this.
And
it's not good for him. It's not good for you.
And as you say all of that, how do you feel right now with all those comments? Remembering
I feel angry.
Yeah, out of 10, how angry do you feel right now?
Still?
Yeah.
Yeah. Still pretty angry.
Yeah. What number would it be?
Let's say 9.
Okay. Yeah. We're just going to go top of the head because she's tuned in. All this anger.
All this anger.
I'm so angry.
I'm so angry.
And I want you to go through the statements of what they said as we tap side of the eye. All this anger when they said.
All this anger when they said, you shouldn't be doing this. You should, this is not how you should parent your child.
All this anger.
All this anger.
You shouldn't be doing this.
You should be doing this.
This is not how you should parent your child. Say anything else you want to say. So acknowledge the anger.
You should be thinking about yourself. This is not good for him.
Tapping the lips.
Leave him crying.
And that makes me angry.
And that makes me very angry.
Top of the head, that makes me very angry.
That makes me very angry because this is my body and my child. No one should be deciding what I should be doing.
Okay, so what we want to do is we keep focused on the anger, don't we? Saying, I'm really angry about this.
And I'm really angry.
I'm really angry about this.
I'm really angry about this.
Where's the anger in your body right now?
My throat.
Yes, your voice, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So all this anger in my throat.
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 And say in your own words why you're angry.
Because they didn't trust me.
Under the arm. All this anger.
All this anger.
Being undermined.
Being undermined.
All this anger.
All this anger.
Because they didn't trust me. It's my decision.
It's my decision.
It's my body.
It's my body.
It's my son.
It's my son.
And I'm angry.
And I'm angry.
Because?
Because I didn't listen to my gut feeling.
Take a breath in. And let it go. Is it still anger? At yourself?
At myself, but also expressing myself.
We might do a setup statement. We've got a bit more information. So even though I'm angry,
even though I'm angry
at myself for not expressing myself, I love and accept myself anyway.
That's
You can stop tapping or you can continue. So you want to carry on. So we don't need to talk, we're just going to tap. And with you, Sarah, we're just tapping. Eyebrow, there's something will shift. Side of the eye, all this upset. You don't need to speak. Under the eye, all this upset.
All this upset.
All this sadness.
All this sadness.
All this upset.
All this upset.
All this upset.
All this upset.
All this sadness.
All this upset.
All this upset.
All this sadness.
All this sadness.
All this upset.
All this upset.
All this sadness.
All this sadness.
All this upset.
All this upset.
All this sadness.
All this sadness.
If you want to take a big breath in. All this upset.
All this upset.
All this sadness.
All this sadness.
Being criticized.
Being criticized.
Not having my voice.
Not having my voice.
Not feeling heard.
Not feeling heard.
It's my body.
It's my body.
It's my son.
It's my son.
I felt so criticized.
I felt so criticized.
And I didn't have a voice.
I didn't have a voice.
All this upset.
All this upset.
All this sadness.
All this sadness.
Just take a big breath in. And let it go.
It's good to let it go.
Yeah.
But this anger,
yes,
turned into empowerment.
It did.
Yeah.
And that's a good thing.
It's a good thing.
Yeah.
I'm still breastfeeding my son.
Yeah.
And he's a great little boy. So that's my way of, you know, when I see him.
Yes.
It's in that moment,
yes,
where,
yes,
being vulnerable,
absolutely,
being criticized, not sure what to do.
Yes.
But I'm, today I'm proud that I,
yes,
continued.
Wonderful.
Trusting me.
Good. So we're going to check things out here because we're demonstrating the movie technique.
Mm-hmm.
So how are you feeling in this moment? There was a lot of upset then. How's that feeling?
Relieved.
Relieved. Good. And that's the direct result of tapping. Of course, that's why we're doing it. So out of 10, how much discomfort is there right now when you think about... Actually, tell me from the beginning again, up until that last point. Can you start the story again from the very beginning?
When I was 1.5, 2, my parents in this house, and I started to cry.
Yeah.
I took care of them.
Yes.
And got criticized for my parenting style.
Yeah.
And
nothing there now when you say that? Okay, carry on.
No. And I felt judged, insecure, but I still did what I thought was good for both my son and myself.
Yeah, and does that feel okay saying all of
fine,
that? Good.
Fine.
Yeah.
And yeah, no, it's okay.
So there's no more to that story?
Yeah, there's always been lots of criticism.
After that,
like
separate to that. Yeah. But this particular story, this particular event, is there any more that you think might still have pieces in it? Like anybody else saying anything later, or it just in this particular movie?
Yeah. And then so I put Night to
okay.
bed. It took a long
yes.
time.
Yes.
And everyone had dinner
yes.
already.
Yes.
It was 10 o'clock.
Okay.
And when I came down, everyone was looking at me.
So
why are you doing this?
When you remember that, and is there any feeling there?
I'm okay with it now.
Out of 10, how much discomfort when you imagine they're there looking at you like, what have you been doing? We've all had dinner.
4.
4? We can bring that down a bit.
5.
Yeah.
If I translate myself back then,
yes.
you know I'm fine with it.
So what we need to do is, as comfortably as you can, is just see yourself there again, just to try and get what's left, because we want to focus on what's there, not just be all, oh, that's all complete. So what do you need to do to be in that moment again? Do you want to tell me again, or do you want to just visualize? What do you need to do? Do you want to visualize?
Yeah.
And just let me know where it shows up in your body.
I would say my throat.
Your throat, and what number is it? The discomfort at everybody looking at you, like what have you been doing all that time? We've had dinner.
8, 9.
8, 9.
I mean, if I'm
yeah,
there.
That's what we want right now.
Yeah.
So it's 8 or 9. What's the feeling? Sadness, fear, anger, frustration,
vulnerable,
bit of
fear,
being judged and not being strong enough to express
sign of the hand.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we do a setup statement because a bit more information. So
even though
I had this fear, and I can feel it in my throat now.
I can feel it in my throat now.
They were judging me. And I didn't have my voice. I felt vulnerable.
I was vulnerable.
I love and accept myself.
And I'm open to having peace with this.
Because I now know the benefit.
Of doing what I
did.
I can see the benefit.
In my son. But right now, when I remember, and just think about it again. Seeing all their faces.
Them judging me.
They'd all had dinner. And I couldn't say what I needed to say.
And
I feel that in my throat right now.
I love and accept myself.
And I'm open to releasing this in my throat now. Good. Top of the head. This fear in my throat.
Not being able to speak up.
This fear in my throat. Not being able to speak up in front of them all. This fear of being judged again. All this fear of not being able to speak. For fear of being judged again. Let's take a breath in. And let it go. Maybe in this space, just imagine that again. Them all in front of you, they've all had dinner. They're looking at you. How do you see yourself now? Or what reaction do you have in your throat?
It's less tension. I feel less overwhelmed.
Less overwhelmed. Just going to get a little bit more creative. This isn't traditional, but it's, I feel, you know, naturally it'll be quite helpful for you. If you were to imagine they were all here, and you could now say what you didn't say,
mm-hmm.
How would that feel to say that now?
Overwhelming.
Yeah. So we just go top of the head. We don't need to do it. All this overwhelm. So we're going to put them all in a bubble. They can't speak or even look at you. Side of the eye. All this overwhelm. Where is it in the body?
All this overwhelm in my throat.
Big breath. Let it go. Hand on your heart when you're ready. Tapping that point. What number is it? The overwhelm, the thought of having your voice with them.
Seven.
And in the throat. So just keep with that.
Mm.
Look hard down left. Straight ahead. Hard down right. Straight ahead. Big breath in. Be aware of your throat. Let it go. Okay, look at 12 o'clock, the ceiling, just follow my finger around. All this overwhelm. Fear of being judged.
Fear of being criticized.
This fear in my throat. Big breath in. And let it go. We'll go the other way, anti-clockwise. First, focus in on it. All this fear.
It's fear in my throat.
All this fear. Fear of being judged.
In front of them all.
Feeling vulnerable.
But having my voice.
Breathing in. Let it go. I'm gonna hum. Let's count to five. One, two, three, four, five. And humming, yeah, breathe. Let it go. Good. Let's hum again. Relax your hands. Take a nice breath in and let it go. How's the throat feeling?
It's less constricted.
Mm-hmm.
I feel that less overwhelmed as well.
Good. me to get you to do it, but they're
I
over
can,
here.
I can now.
You can now. Do you want them in the bubble or out the bubble?
In the bubble. Okay.
In the bubble. So they're in the bubble here. Tap the side with your hands. Is there anything you want to say to them?
it's my child, my body. Appreciate your arguments for what you have to say, but this is me and my family, and if
actually
it's okay,
the head and just keep talking to them if you like. This is me.
You need to trust me.
Yeah.
There are different parenting styles. I don't criticize your way of parenting, so please don't criticize my way.
How's that feeling as you're doing that now?
Empowering.
Empowering, good. Would you, yeah, keep going.
Noah's never sick, thanks to breastfeeding. And then I could tell them all the, if you want, I can send you some research on benefits of breastfeeding. Like
good. How does that all feel?
Good.
Big breath in. Let it go. Shortening this up a little bit, but actually I hope this is moving, which is good. And this is really about, you can see where it's going with your belief about yourself as well and having a voice, etc. So let's just test. Remember, we're just going to test this out one last time, and then we're just going to establish if there's any still limiting belief in there or if it's shifted, and then we'll complete at this stage. So the beauty of the movie technique, tell the story, of course, is that we can run through it again and check the pieces and see if there's any reaction. So that's what we'll do now. So start from the beginning, right up until you came back downstairs and they were there. And just tell me if there's anything that comes up.
When I was 1.5, he was crying and I took care of him. I was with my family in those house and we went up with Noah and I got criticized for my parenting style. Attachment parenting, co-sleeping, breastfeeding. And when I came back down, when I was 10, everyone had had dinner and everyone was looking at me with big eyes.
When you say that, is there a reaction?
No.
Good, yeah. And that, okay, and that was the, that was it?
Yeah.
Was there a,
yeah.
Yeah. Okay, and what's your general feeling now? So if we just check one last thing, which is always really helpful when we've done the movie technique, what do you think that made you mean about yourself or the world in a limiting way? Is there anything that you think you made that mean? Yeah. Like
by
a limiting belief about yourself.
Like that?
Yeah.
Not good enough.
And is that ringing true right now? And it might play out, of course, in other areas of your life, because we're human and it does, but in this particular movie, it's not holding, is that right, that you're not good enough? And that's the beauty of doing this technique, because you've now cleared that particular experience, which if you don't, of course, will just keep playing out, won't it, in other areas, another imprint. Okay, wonderful. How's your throat feeling?
Clearer.
Okay, thanks, Sarah. Thanks so much for being a volunteer.
Thank you for holding space.
So, any questions?